CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.5, Compare and Contrast Storage Types. Read and Write. It is time to break away from the exam objectives for a moment and do a bit more bonus teaching in order to discuss read and write. Data read and write operations are a foundational topic with various applications, including software development, database management, data analysis, and file storage. And I feel this is the perfect time to talk about read and write, as we have just finished working with storage drives. Okay, so what is a read? A read involves retrieving information from a storage device and bringing it into the computer's system memory for processing. Some synonyms we have used for read have been access and retrieve. A read would also be considered a drive output operation. Now that we have defined read, write is mostly the opposite. A write involves storing or updating information on a storage device, allowing you to modify existing data or add new data. A write would also be considered a drive input operation. With read and write defined, we can now move on to some performance metrics that help us to evaluate a storage drive. I will first cover transfer rates. A transfer rate, also known as data rate, is very similar to throughput, but instead represents the speed at which data can be read from, or written to, a storage drive, as opposed to the speed at which data moves between locations. Also, transfer rates are usually measured in bytes per second, with a uppercase B, bytes, as opposed to throughput being measured in bits per second, with a lowercase b, bits. Okay, to summarize transfer rates. Read speed is how fast a drive can retrieve information when requested. Write speed is how fast a drive can record or store incoming data. Looking at the image behind me, 3.1 megabytes per second read speed means data is currently being retrieved from this drive at a rate of 3.1 megabytes of data every second. Any thoughts on how long it is going to take if the file being retrieved is 31 megabytes in total? That's right. It will take approximately 10 seconds. In addition to transfer rates, we can measure a storage drive's performance based on IOPS. IOPS stands for input-output operations per second, and is a performance metric that measures the number of read and write operations a storage device can handle in 1 second. Calculating IOPS involves two parts, the average size of each operation and the storage drive's transfer rate. The average operation size refers to the amount of data read from or written to the storage device in a single operation, and is typically measured in bytes. The transfer rate represents the amount of data that can be read from or written to the storage device per second. Now to calculate IOPS, take the transfer rate and divide it by the average operation size. While you may not see this information right away in your IT journey, it will prove useful in time. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.